just as family and friends gathered here at the Lutheran Church in Blairsville to remember the Tolley sisters, the state police fire marshal believes he is getting closer to pinpointing a cause for the fire that killed them. He's now focused on the entertainment center and the wiring behind it. Their deaths have been ruled an accident, likely due to electrical causes. And following the investigation closely, the police officer who tried desperately to save the girls from the fire Sunday morning. He tried to get inside, but the smoke was too thick. Only on 4, he told us why he volunteered to lead the funeral procession, with pictures of 7-year-old Kirsten and 6-year-old Katrina taped to his windows.
I ended up in front of the line because I had a personal relationship with the kids and the parents, and I felt that it was my responsibility to show my support and lead the procession.
The girls were at a sleepover when flames broke out in the living room of a home on Blairsville Stewart Street. Despite efforts by the homeowners, they could not be saved from a back bedroom where they were sleeping. That couple came to the service too and embraced the girls' mother and stepfather. Their mother just gave birth 2 weeks ago to a baby girl, and with her other 4-year-old daughter by her side, had to bury 2 of her children. Not a dry eye at the funeral while mourners sang Kirsten's favorite song, Jesus Loves Me.
Words never can adequately express such a horrible grief at this time, but we can reach out to one another in love. And that reaching out says more than any word ever could.
And the community is reaching out by sending donations to the Tolley Sisters Trust at PNC Bank. In Blairsville, Indiana County, I'm Jennifer Mealy, Channel 4 Action News.